Good morning students. So this video is the second part of the learning curve, where we have in the first part we have discussed about the learning curve function, which is fx is equals to capital A x to the power alpha, and to calculate the number of labor hours required to produce range A to B production, then integral A to B fx dx, where fx is a learning curve function, integral A to B capital A x to the power alpha dx. So here capital A is always positive, it is greater than 0, and alpha is lies between minus 1 to 0. So let's see in some of the illustrations. The illustration is a firm manufactures 500 air conditioned per day. It is observed that the rate of change of production with respect to the additional number of workers employed, that is x, is given by 100 minus 6 x to the power 1 by 2. If the firm employed 16 more workers, then estimate the new level of production. So the company is earlier producing 5000 air conditions per day, and it's been observed that rate of change of production, jo change hai with respect to the additional number of workers, that is with the workers employed x, the function is 100 minus 6x to the power 1 by 2. So this is the rate of change, and then they want to introduce 16 more new workers, then what will be the new level of production? So let's see how we calculate the production. So here let P be the level of production, and they have given the change in the production with respect to the workers, with respect to the x workers. It is 100 minus 6 x to the power 1 by 2. So I'll take dx there. So dp is equals to 100 minus 6 x to the power 1 by 2 dx, and here we'll take the integration both sides. So integration of dp is equals to integration of 100 minus 6 x to the power 1 by 2 dx. So here p will be 100 into x minus 6 into x to the power 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2 plus the constant k. So the level of production p will be 100x minus 4 x to the power 3 by 2, because 2 will goes here and 3 is 6 cancel ho jayega 2 times, then it will be 4 x to the power 3 by 2 plus k, where k is a constant of integrations. So now if no change in the number of workers, then x is 0. Agar old workers, jitne old number of workers hain, usse alawa koi aur new workers hum nahi le rahe hain, then the old number of workers, there is no change in the number of workers, then x is equals to 0, and the initial production is 500. So the level of production p is equals to 5000. So level of production p is equal to 5000 when we are not changing number of workers, means x is equals to 0. So using the same formula, the production p is equals to 5000, and substituting x is equals to 0 here, so that we are able to find out the value of k, constant term, which is 5000. So now here production will be 100x minus 4 x to the power 3 by 2 plus 5000. This is your equation number 1. This is the level of production when we are not introducing new workers. Now the question is asking, if we are introducing 16 new workers, then what will be the level of production? So here the production at x is equal to 16, we are introducing 16 new labor, then P is equals to 100 into 16. We are placing in the equation number 1 of the level of production, I'll substitute value of x is 16. So 100 into 16 minus 4 into 16 to the power 3 by 2 plus 5000. I'll simplify it, then the level of production will be 6344. Hence the production when 16 labor increase, the production will be 6344. Now let's see then another example. After producing 35 units of a product, the production manager determines that the production facility is following the learning curve of the form fx is equals to 300 minus 190 e to the power minus 2x, where fx is the rate of labor hour. required to produce xth unit. Then how many labor hours required to produce xth unit and how many labor hours would be required to produce additional 25 units. So earlier they are producing 35 units and they want to know if they are producing 25 more units, then how many labor hours is required. So here we have the given function fx is equals to 300 minus 190 e to the power minus 2x for producing 35 units. So capital N, now I am producing 25 more workers, 25 more products. So earlier they were producing 35 units, now they are producing 25 more, so 35 plus 25 and 300 minus 190 e to the power minus 2x dx. Now let's see, I'll take the integration. So here capital N will be 300x minus 190 e to the power minus 2x upon minus 2 and the range will be 35 to 60. So capital N will be 300, we'll substitute the upper limit for 60. And here minus minus become plus 190 by 2 e to the power minus 120. And then substituting in place of x 60, then it is 120. And then minus 9 and 300 into 35 plus 190 by 2 e to the power minus 70. If I'll simplify it, so the number of labor hours required to produce additional 25 units, it will be 10,500 plus 95. E to the power minus 120 minus e to the power minus 70. So this will be your solution.